What's up, guys? It's Mr. Adesai here. So today I've got another one of my little informative videos. I've been posting quite a few more gameplay videos as of recent, but this video is going to be on the robot classifications in the game, and it just might help you optimize your hangar just a little bit more than you already have. So when robots first started, their classifications were very simple. You had light robots, medium robots, and heavy robots. Throughout the game, you'd see that light robots, for the most part, were just your starter robots. You'd have like the Destrier and the Schutzi and the Jeopard, and they weren't really robots that anybody would be doing well in higher leagues. I mean, yeah, there was that thing with the whole Jeopard with Magnum's exploit, but that wasn't really because the Jeopard was good, it was just because it was bad, actually. But anyway, so their whole classification basically had light robots being the worst robots in the low leagues, medium ones being good in medium leagues, but some exceptional medium ones actually even being good in high leagues, such as the Brigatka, and then the heavy robots were the big meta, like the Lancelot and the Griffin, very, very much the Griffin, and even the Leo. And that was at the time, obviously. With the release of the Dashbots, which was quite a bit ago, Pixonic had completely stepped away from the light, medium, heavy thing. You know, people automatically assumed, well, Kumiho must be light, and Hayachi must be medium, and Bulgasari is heavy. And from an outwards perspective, it definitely looks like that, even though Kumiho still was really good even in higher leagues, especially in comparison to all the bots at the time. It was basically just a better Rogatka, but, you know, that's how they had been releasing bots the whole time. You'd have the, before the Dash bots, there were the Brit bot pack, and it was a light one, a medium one, and a heavy one. And Warbots did for a time actually continue releasing bots in packs of three, like the the Ragnarok squad, and they were still what appeared to be a light robot Loki, a medium robot Tyr, and a heavy robot Fenrir. At this point, Pixonic had completely stepped away from the light, medium, and heavy classifications. All of the classifications have been changed, and that's what this video is about. I want to tell everyone, basically, give you guys an idea of what classifications currently exist within the game. So let's start here with the Saboteur. The Saboteur is one of the very popular classes that is basically what the light robots ended up becoming. The future of light robots became Saboteur robots. Instead of releasing a robot pack where you'd have a light robot and whatever, if they wanted to release what would be a light robot, they instead considered it a Saboteur. A Saboteur is essentially a robot that can easily get around the map, getting behind enemy lines, and really just it's not having as much firepower, but in the right hands you could utilize that little firepower to still deal a ton of damage. For example, even though a Phantom only has one medium and two light weapons in comparison to something like a Leech, which has four medium weapons, you can still do a ton of damage with those as shotguns, because you can get close and behind your enemies and surprise them and then get back to your teleported location. The Loki can do a similar thing where you can use three gusts, fill your enemy with lead, and then go right back into stealth and escape. And that's basically the point of Saboteur class robots. They are supposed to be able to, well, get in, get out. And also, they're very good beacon runners. A lot of the players had called light robots for a long time beacon runners, and Saboteur robots, well, they run beacons. They're able to, again, get back behind enemy lines, and you can really easily just snatch beacons right out under your enemy's nose. There's so many times where you'll just be in a Loki, and there's Ao Mings flying around, the heaviest of heavy robots, and you'll just take the beacon and run away. And it's pretty crazy to be able to see that. And, by the way, there actually are Titans are considered in these classes. It's not like Titan's a classification of itself. However, currently, Saboteur is the only robot that does not have a Titan, but it is confirmed by Pixonic that Saboteur will be the next Titan. Titan number 5 will be a Saboteur Titan, and I'm currently predicting that it will be a Dashing Titan, because really with the Titans, they've been going like back in time. You know, they released the Kid, and they released the Arthur, and those are supposed to be, well, they're like basically the Titan version of the Brit Bots and the Wild West Bunch. So, they're kind of going back a little bit, and I think that the Dash Robots will be getting a big, heavy Saboteur Titan. Although I really don't know how it's going to work. But obviously, as we go on to the next classifications, I will also show the Titans. But for now, no Titan exists in the Saboteur class, and I'm sure that Pictonic is having some trouble actually creating a Saboteur Titan, because, well, Titans are these big, heavy, slow behemoths. It's pretty hard to make that thing fast and, well, balanced. But yeah, basically, Saboteur robots, get in, get out, get beacons, get behind. That's all you gotta know, and usually it's good to be running a Saboteur robot in your hangar. And, you know, a lot of them can be very well used just for the aforementioned needs. Anyway, let's get on to the next one. The second classification I would like to talk about is essentially what the heavy robots turned into, tanks. It might be surprising to see Ravana here, although I'm sure that Fenrir is an obvious no-go. Of course Fenrir is a tank, but Ravana actually is also classified as a tank, and the reason this is because Ravana takes basically a lot of fire. It's not just that Ravana has a massive health pool, which it does. I believe its raw health is actually the most in the game, but its ability allows it to dodge a lot of fire and basically take up all the enemy space. Although yeah, you're not really protecting your teammates because they can shoot right through you, they're still usually locked onto you and waiting for you to come out of your phase shift, and since it can phase shift so much, it basically does exactly what a tank does. It attracts the enemy's fire and their attention so that the DPS can deal damage. So Ravana is, well, pretty good at doing its job, as it's really a meta robot, but after the nerf it might not be as good. Fenrir was a popular tank before Ravana came out, and Falcon is also a popular tank, although internally Falcon isn't really classified as a tank. Falcon was meant to be one of those big, like, brawling robots, but since the traditional skill exists, it technically was turned into a tank, but that's just how it's most commonly used. If you use it without traditionalist, which is how it was originally meant to be used, it is a brawler. One thing that is very obvious in tanks, unlike the similar to the Saboteurs, they have relatively low firepower in comparison to some of their brawling counterparts. While yes, two heavies and a heavy and two mediums and three mediums is of course quite a bit of firepower, when you get in the high leagues and you have, well, the Leech, for example, with four mediums, it's beating you in firepower, just raw firepower, of course. And there's like the Hawk with two heavies and two lights. Those are like the real firepower guys. Tanks are mostly meant to just be able to absorb damage, so their health pools are obviously far above average, or if they don't have very high health pools, then they make up for it with resistance. That's basically what the Fenrir does. While its health isn't that high, its health basically gets doubled by its 50% resistance. There's also the Invader, which isn't shown here, but it was a popular tank back in the day. Recently, it's been kind of taken over by the Fenrir. And as I said, yes, I will also be going over the Titans and their classification, and unlike Saboteur, Tank does have a Titan in its classification, and this is, well, obviously, the Arthur. The Arthur is the essence of a tank. It's a Titan tank. It's a tank tank. In comparison to something like, well, the Ao Ming, which is supposed to be a bit of more of a damage dealer, you have this Titan, which is mostly health based. You have that big shield, you have that big health pool, and you have one heavy weapon less firepower. Weakest of all the Titans, it is the Titan that is just for that category. All Titans are for this category, but this Titan fulfills that the best, and it is the tank role. Anyway, so just let's get more about like what tanks actually do. So obviously, as I said, they take a lot of damage. They're supposed to be able to protect their teammates. In fact, since the Arthur is so huge, you're able to just hide your robot behind the Arthur. This really makes it just so good for pushing. This is something that is often done in a lot of games. You have these tanks that have huge shields covering their whole team and pushing important objectives. Ravana and Fenrir, they're just normal bots. They don't do it as well as Arthur does. Obviously, it's a Titan, but they still all do it. But I think that's about it for the whole tank category, and we'll get on to the next category. And next up, we have the Brawlers. War Robots Brawlers are one of the most extensive popular robot classes that there are in the game. Often Pixonic actually refers to them as glass cannons, because that's really what they are. They have massive amounts of firepower and an amazing ability that really enhances them and allows them to use that firepower. But when they're without their ability, they are made of glass. The Leech is a very popular example. It has 4 heavy weapons, which is an absolute load of heavy weapons. It's so strong. But it gets vaporized if it doesn't have its ability. With its ability, it's a menace running towards you with those 4 shotguns and just absolutely shredding you to pieces. But if you can catch it when its ability is down, it's so fragile and basically has nothing but that 5 seconds its last stand gives it to get away from you. If its last stand is that leveled up that high. Not all brawlers are glass cannons, though. The Hawk, for example, while it is a lot more fragile than the tank, it isn't completely made of paper thin when it doesn't have its ability, because, it puts its weapons away when it goes into its ability. You're still capable of using its weapons without the ability, it's just you have to really choose your fights wisely. For example, with a Hawk, you probably want to fight a Leech that doesn't have its ability, not something like a tank that doesn't really need an ability unless you have your ability. The Brawler class Titan is the Kid. Surprisingly, the Kid, it is the worst Titan of them all. It is the free Titan. It's your training wheels Titan. It's just the Titan that you use to actually get to understand Titans and then know how they work. But specifically, the Kid is just... It's meant for, dealing damage, as brawlers are. They did want to classify all the Titans, and there will likely, after the Saboteur Titan, be released a better Brawler Titan, because they need to have some sort of starter Titan, and Kid, as we know, it's basically inferior to all the Titans in every way, but the thing that really makes it stand out as actually being some sort of brawler is that when it uses its ability, it's basically does the whole glass cannon thing. You're really weak without your ability. You just have those 2 baby Titan weapons, but when you use your ability, you get the big weapon and you get a ton of resistance. I think it could really use getting increased speed as well, but that's up to the developers. So I think that Kid really does show the essence of a brawler, but it just needs to be beefed up in some way. It needs some sort of more protection, because the Titan itself doesn't really, it's not able to beat really any of the other Titans. Even the support Titan, the Nodens, it will lose to it, and that's solely because its ability gives it more damage resistance, but all Titans negate damage resistance. So I think that the Kid would actually be good as a brawler, and actually be balanced alongside the other Titans instead of just being the free Titan that isn't good, if it actually gained that sort of damage resistance that the Hawk has, where it cannot be penetrated by the other Titan's weapons. This would actually give it that, and also if it gets increased speed when it's in its ability, because this is the only robot, the only Titan that has its really cool down ability, and you need to use that ability to be strong. It feels like basically if the Leech, instead of when it uses its ability, it becomes really strong, and all it did was allow it to use all 4 of its medium weapons and normally can only use 2. And I think that's basically where the Kid loses out. If they had balanced it, because the Kid is obviously intentionally balanced to be not that good. It's meant to be the low league, I just became level 30, now I have my new Titan. It's just not a very... It loses to every other Titan. But if they did intend to balance it properly, this would be a very good brawler. I'm sure that certainly, at some point, we will see another Brawler Titan, but as it is, this is basically brawlers. They are characterized by their below average health, but very high firepower and very powerful abilities. Let's get on to the next one. Okay, and the next one is support. Support is currently a popular class that's entirely dominated by the Nightingale, but the Mender was one of the first supports to ever come out. We had the Mender, the Wayland, they came out together first, and then the Tyr and the Nightingale. Currently, the support class is the least dense class at the moment. There are simply not that many support class robots, and I really think that the support class as a whole needs a buff, because even though the Nightingale itself is an extremely powerful robot in general, it's just such a good robot, it's such a good healer, the fact that like Nightingale is the only good healer is definitely a problem. One thing that I wanted to note about support is you don't really need to be a healer to be a support. Pixonic actually classifies the Raker as a support class robot, and this is just because its ability is very supportive to your team. You shoot somebody from far away and suppress their weapons, effectively giving your teammates a lot of leeway in fighting the enemies. So while yes, support robots often heal their teammates, they are also just able, suppression robots in general. Like, I'd say basically just this Raker at the moment is the only support class robot that does not heal. That's all I can think of off the top of my head. But the Nightingale and the Mender, obviously Nightingale, of course, does suppress just like the Raker, and it also heals. I think the Nightingale's a better version of Raker, but before Nightingale existed, Raker was basically the best at suppressing enemies for your team. So it definitely, like, it was good for supporting your team. It's not like a brawler, it doesn't fit anywhere other than support. But as I said, the support class, it's basically, you have low firepower, okay health, and an ability that helps your teammates. It really depends on, like, it goes from robot to robot, what their health is. Like, Raker is paper thin, but like Mender gets really strong when it uses its ability, and it in general just has quite a bit of health, but they all have pretty low firepower. As you can see, you have Mender with one medium, two lights, and then Nightingale with two mediums, one light, and Raker with one heavy, two lights. None of them really have that great firepower. Wayland probably has the best firepower of all of them, or maybe Tyr, it's really between them. But in general, you can see these, like, they're not as high firepower as something like a Leech. They don't even come close. All of them work in the way that their ability is based on helping your team in some sort of way, whether it be healing, suppressing, or healing and suppressing. And of course, we can't forget it's behind the Raker. Okay, here we go. Now it's in front of the Raker. So, we have the Nodens Titan, which also both heals and suppresses. This is the support Titan. The Nodens Titan is definitely one of the best Titans in the current meta, and when I say one of the best Titans, I mean it's not Kid. It's obviously, as you can see, it has just the four light weapons. There's not a single heavy Titan weapon to be seen here, and that is because as a support robot, it is not supposed to have very high firepower. In fact, while you might think that like four light weapons is similar firepower to something like an Arthur, if you look at the actual resistance bypass on all of the weapons, small beta weapons, they only get 75% resistance bypass at max, and heavy ones get 100% resistance bypass at max. What this means is the Nodens is never able to actually completely bypass resistance, whereas something like an Arthur has one weapon that can. So its firepower is really limited when fighting other Titans, although it's still pretty good against normal bots. I find that just this whole class, it is fun to play and your teammates will absolutely love you, but yourself you're like really vulnerable, which is normal for a support, but still I think that we could use more support bots. We could use buffs to things like Raker, which are just completely useless in the face of a Nightingale. I'm happy that we're seeing buffs to Mender and Wayland. They definitely need it so that they could actually like stack up with Nightingale, although I still think that Nightingale will without a doubt be the best healer. There's just no beating going stealth, flying around for a really long time. Like, it's basically just like the love child of a Loki, a Raker, and a Wayland, and an Aojun, and there's just so much to it, and it's so good. I don't think that they should necessarily nerf it, because that is what all support robots should be. They should be that great. They should be amazing at helping your team, because at the moment, like, support robots, when they first came out, you basically just had Mender and Wayland, and if you wanted to heal your robot, you needed a Mender or Wayland. But shortly after that, they added modules, and now basically anyone can just heal by clicking a button. No other robot. So these robots just become a lot like cast into the shadows, because most players can just heal themselves. They don't need a support anymore. And that's why like support are very necessary in games like Overwatch. In Overwatch, you can't heal yourself unless you are like a support. There are some special, you know, like a Roadhog, which is a tank, can't heal itself, but that's because he's a tank. But in general, if you're playing like a DPS, like a leech, basically the equivalent of an Overwatch is the equivalent of a leech, you can't heal yourself. You can't just click the button and regain like 50% of your health. You have to go find a med kit, or your support teammate has to help you. So I think that maybe nerfing the repair modules could do something for this, but I prefer to see buffs over nerfs. And overall, just healing, buffing all of the speed, the radius, the healing, everything, just making these guys really tough, that is what I want to see. I'm happy to see it happen to Mender and Wayland, although I still think Wayland could use a little bit. Mender is going to be really good after the buff. Although Raker probably could use something, like if they just added one simple thing, like the ability to ignore anti-control with the suppression beams, then this would become one of the top supports. It would be able to beat Nightingale somewhere. Nightingale can't suppress someone if they have anti-control. Well, it can, but it just has to keep shooting and waiting for the anti-control to wear off, and by then they can get to cover. The Raker, if it were able to just bypass an anti-control, you could just suppress, bam, 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 suppress three enemies, and then your team can push, and you've been the best support ever. Or maybe, like, you can shoot your little lasers at your teammates and heal them. But anyway, I've rambled off too much. Let's get on to the next one, and, of course, the final one. Before I start talking about the sniper class, I would like to inform you all that Wayland is not really a sniper. It is obviously support, as I just got done talking about, but I can't actually find an image of the Jaeger anywhere, and as you guys may know, the Jaeger is the new upcoming robot in the test server, and it is meant to be a sniper. So Wayland kind of looks like a Jaeger, has the same weapon hardpoint, so whatever, that Wayland is a Jaeger. In fact, I wrote Jaeger on it, so now you know that's a Rager. It's not a Wayland. But anyway, so as you can see, the snipers are robots that have above average firepower, like a lot of firepower. As you can see, like with the Behemoth, for example, the Behemoth has 4 heavy slots. That's the most in the game. The Ao Ming also has the most Titan weapons of any Titan, and it currently has the most firepower. Although, personally, and I use Ao Ming as a close range, what's it called, a brawler. A lot of people do, and there's nothing wrong with that. That's a great idea, because the Dragoon weapons for the Titans are very expensive. But the Ao Ming was created with the intention of being a sniper, and it actually does that best, as you can see by all the Dragoon Ao Mings that fly around and vaporize your robot in seconds. But it is possible to run it. It's like, just as you can put your glaciers on your Behemoth, you can also put your machine guns on your Ao Ming, and it'll still kind of do okay. The reason that snipers, despite their massive amount of firepower like the Behemoth, aren't like hyper meta and absolutely destroying all the DPS is because they don't have that sort of crazy ability that lets them destroy robots. Like, for example, like even though the Leech has a lot less firepower with only 4 mediums and not 4 heavies, the Leech has an ability to make it so that no matter how much you shoot with those 4 heavies, you're only going to be killing yourself. And also, like the Jaeger, I don't really know much about that, I can't really say anything, but I don't think that anybody's going to really be running that at a close range, just because it's so optimized for long range. But like, either way, you can still go on a sniper and you can run really close range weapons. It's just, since you are, usually you're huge, you have a massive hitbox, even though you might have a lot of health, you don't have any ability to help you with that health. Like, Behemoth might have a ton of health, but like those 4 mediums will still rip through you. You're not able to help yourself at a close range. So if you catch a leech off guard, where it has no ability, of course your 4 thunders or glaciers or exoduses will like absolutely vaporize it and just make it disappear. Did you really need 4 thunders or glaciers or exoduses to do that? The reason these robots have such massive amounts of firepower in general is because you can put a lot of snipers on them, because each individual sniper does really bad damage. For example, the damage of a thunder and a trebuchet for one shot are basically equal. A trebuchet, to get that one shot, takes 23 seconds. A thunder can constantly shoot that shot over and over and over. The difference is that the trebuchet can do that damage from 1,100 meters, and the thunder has to be touching your enemy. So, while you have very bad DPS in comparison, like, yeah, that shot does a lot of damage when you hit people, you have to wait a long time before you can hit again. I think that this whole sniper class needs a buff even more than the support class. The sniper class is so underused, and I can't right now think of any sniper robot that's, like, really meta. Nobody's really using snipers. Obviously the Yao Ming, but that's because, like, it was kind of made with the intention of being this big meta thing. But, like, now it had its whole meta shining moment where you just sat at 600 meters with dragoons and vaporized everyone. But now, like, they released the Scourge weapons for the Titans, and putting Scourges on, like, an Arthur, or even fighting an Yao Ming with an Arthur, even if you don't have Scourges, even if you're lower level, if you can get close to it, you're gonna kill it. The Scourge weapons are now, like, better than the Dragoon weapons in a lot of ways. So, like, the sniper Yao Ming is already seeing itself falling out of the meta. The Behemoth, like, it was basically dead on arrival. Nobody wanted a Behemoth. If you want a Behemoth, you sold it for that 5 million silver. Everybody wanted the Phantom. The Phantom and the Behemoth came together, and, like, nobody cared about the Behemoth, even though it was the first robot to be able to stack up 4 heavy weapons. I think an excellent way to buff the snipers is really just to give them, like, some sort of damage resistance, to give them some sort of passive, basically make them something like a tank. At the moment, if you're running a sniper with close range weapons, you're screwed. If you're running a sniper with long range weapons, if you can go really high level, and you can maybe kill a few people from long range, but it's not that hard for a Ravana to go invisibility mode, run up to you, and eat you to death with those frickin' 3 storms. It's just not, you're completely defenseless. So I think snipers should be a lot harder to take out. Now, obviously, making them more mobile isn't gonna really be reasonable. Like, why would you have this Behemoth able to dash and jump around? I think giving it, like, when it's in its siege mode, like, 50% resistance would be fair, because if somebody is using it with thunders or something, then they'd stand a chance, although they're not supposed to use it that way. But if somebody was using it the way it's meant to be used, with trebuchets or the new upcoming heavy weapon, I think it's, like, Gauss, or I think it might be called Gauss, or Volt is the light one. I don't remember what the medium one is called, but either way, you're using these long-range 800, 600-meter weapons. Like, at least you'll have a chance when somebody comes up to you. Or maybe you could introduce modules that are able to ignore phase shift or something. Or it's just, like, currently there's so much potential for snipers. Like, there's even a pilot that gives it 7.5% more damage, which is more than Adrian, but it only works on 800-meter plus weapons. I think it would even do all the snipers a long way if that pilot got buffed to support 600-meter weapons, and things like Dragoons would become more popular on something like a Behemoth. But in general, the sniper class just seems to be kind of really underappreciated. I think that with what Pixonic is trying to do right now, the sniper class will become much more meta. They're releasing 3 new ranged weapons, they're releasing a new ranged bot, but I hope that this isn't just gonna be like, okay, these 3 sniper weapons and this 1 sniper bot are good, the rest suck. I think something like a Behemoth or a Fury or a Butch should also get some sort of buff to become better, because the essence of a sniper right now is just, well, sniper's bad, damage good, everybody wants to get close, use those weapons or whatever. So, my only proposed buff is really just give snipers a bunch more health, or maybe release snipers. Some sort of snipers could have mobility. I think that, like, the Jaeger kind of has mobility, but, like, when you go into shield mode, you don't have any more mobility. So it's really difficult, but I'm sure the Pixonic balance team would be able to figure this out. You know, they're a balance team. I'm a guy on YouTube just making videos. But yeah, that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed and you're a little bit more informed now about all the War Robots classes and why the heavy, medium, and light classes are gone, what classes are good, and what you should have in your hangar. I'm going to tell you the optimal hangar that you should have. Right now, I guess the only thing I can think of, you usually want to have 1 Saboteur, 1 tank, and three brawlers, or maybe, you know, two brawlers and a support. Right now, like, most of the meta is tanks, brawlers. It's really just however, whatever robots you enjoy playing. I don't think that I could, like, recommend using snipers in the meta. There's just, there, like, if you enjoy that playstyle, go ahead. But if you would like to use some sort of balanced hanger, then you usually want to have, like, one of everything except for a sniper, or replace that with a tank or a brawler. You don't have to do that, though, because, you know, like, I use a hanger with a bunch of leeches, and the top players are using hangers with full Ravanas, and they're doing great, just because the balancing for some of the robots in some of the classes just is really off. So I think that that definitely needs to be looked at, but if this game did have a bit more balance in it, and some of the robots were more closely together, then I think that there would be a long way to be gone. But alas, we have it how it is, and go ahead, run around with your five Ravanas, or you could make a hangar balanced robots. I'll keep running around with five leeches. I'll run around with flying robots, which are basically all damage dealers, but it's just, yeah. However any individual player wishes to play the game is their own discretion and not mine. And I simply made this video so that you guys can just be informed more as to how the classes work. Anyway, I've rambled for way too long, so that is all I have to say. Thank you for watching my video. It's been Mr. Adazahi, and I will catch you on the flip side.